He's too fast. Lure him into the tar field. That should slow him down. This one's out. I'm moving to another valve. I'm ready. Lure him in. Murray, these pumps are out of tar. I saw some more valves over by the cop station. Follow me to a fresh supply.
Without the tar, I'll crush you boys like a bugs! You may have more tar, but I am not holding back no longer. Listen to the song of your death!
The Murray knows no song, but the triumphant horn section of his own triumph!
Quit talking, stupid kid, and die!
The valve's empty. I'll crack another. The tar's ready to flow. This one's out. I'm moving to another valve. Ready with the tar. Looks tough. Might take some more bombs. company. Just stay on those tar pipes. This could get hairy. This is getting serious. Better hurry it up with those pipes.
Shock on! Turn it on! Crank it up!
Let go of me, you geriatric fiend!
Shut up and hold still!
You for this.
You won't get nothing for the grave, pal.
Sly, hurry it up!
Pipe it down, lunch meat. Activate!
Press the L1 button to go into ball form. Hit the X button on impact to keep your bounces high. I'm projecting some markers to help you find the tar drums.
Heads up!
This is great, Murray. Those tar drums are an integral part of Octavio's scheme. With them out of the picture, you're that much closer to seeing the black water run clear. I promise. Superb bouncing, chum. That tar drum didn't know what hit it. In a peaceful sense, of course. Keep this up, and the environmentalist will send a thank you card.
Coming down!
Yeah.
Scratch one blue Viper.
This place is packed with wall hooks. The miners must use them to haul up their drills. Looks like you're going to get some rock climbing practice.
Up the environment or anything, but these caves are rich with opals. I can see why these miners are so driven.
Oh, my God.
guns! That pumping has got me pumped!
Thank you.
should do it.
Snack time! Chew that miner like bubblegum! Eat up, pal! Chomp that clown in half! Hungry little fella? Delicious miners! Wonder if they taste good.
Sly, you okay?
Right as rain, pal.
Good one, Sly!
Just keep coming. You holding up, Murray?
Feeling strong. Behold my powers of destruction.
Well struck, Murray.
You're looking good, Murray. Guy. Give it to him, pal.
On guard!
Keep your distance.
This law, girl! Did you chip a nail, sweetheart?
That's 10 fewer pilots in the finals tomorrow. One more pilot, and it's a done deal.
afraid of heights.
Get that pink punk! These doors ain't holding themselves open! Keep it coming! I'm a brick wall! Take it all day, lightweight.
Ha 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 ha.
Starts tomorrow. Where are all my guards?
Asleep?
Watching TV? Bother paying them at all. Allowing them to welcome tourists. I tell you, Christoph, the Aces pilots get better and better.
We've got some real competition on our hands this year. I'm not saying it's too much for Team Black Baron.
No. We've done a fine job training.
Our pilots are in tip-top condition. The best lot, without question. Truly. This is going to be our fight.
might stop my body, but my spirit's on fire!
Directions in the air with your double jump.
Come back and take it like a man.
Thank you.
up behind him and pickpocket the screws from his peg leg.
This guy's clear.
Take that!
Genetic energy.
My ancestors sure knew how to decorate. Nothing but big piles of gold.
Thank you. Nice work, Dad.
Thank you.
talk about some of the earlier stuff produced for Sly. I'm Dev Medan, art director of Sucker Punch.
I'm Nate Fox, I'm one of the game designers.
And what we're looking at here is a level that was produced, but never made it into the game.
Well, it made it into the game spiritually.
Yes, spiritually.
I mean, you can tell. It's like a big, impressive, kind of Riviera feel, high class, very Sly Cooper style.
Yeah, just figuring out the evolution of the gameplay between Sly 1 and Sly 2. So what, 6 months we worked on this? 8 months?
Yeah, a shamefully long amount of time. And it didn't even make it into the game.
Yeah.
But it was sort of the conceptual building block for how we were going to construct Sly 2, which was a big departure from Sly 1. I mean,
lovely.
You can tell it's all non-linear in how you move through this space.
Lovely.
Which is pretty radical shift for us. I remember in this level, we were going to have a Bentley steal a giant yacht and smash it through all of these docks and eventually bash it into that large building, which was a casino, so that the Cooper gang could pull off a pretty sweet heist.
Those are the smartest guards ever.
I know. But at least they stand at attention, you know. Sly attacks them and they're there. They're very present emotionally. I love this cop boat because it features the fine Sucker Punch tradition of writing poor French on things.
10 months, so we're now back at Sly 1.
Do you read me?
Yeah, Bentley, I hear ya.
I've just identified a potential problem. See that filthy game?
I love, you know, we kept the same Bentley from the very first voice experiment.
Okay.
But that's Sly.
A chance for me to bust out my new climb move.
Climb move! Oh! Man! If you ever wanted to punch the character in the face more,
that would be it.
Bentley's a pretty interesting guy, the voice of Bentley. He's a friend of the fellow in the office. He worked in a record store down the street from me.
Jump and hit the circle to
be nice to go in and get a recommendation on an album.
And he ended up being the voice of Bentley.
Yeah. Well, it'll give you record recommendations in the Bentley voice.
I think you want about the one. Two shelves down.
Yeah, how many times? Oh, look at the dancing cash. Yeah. Nothing says video game good times like
dancing cash.
Dancing inanimate. Well, I guess it is animate if it's dancing.
Oh, man, even this music I remember. I can't listen to this CD anymore.
So this is the same level we're just looking at, just in a obviously much more primitive form.
Oh, the animations.
Oh, yeah. Sly looks like he's got a problem.
Yeah.
What's his deal? If you saw somebody in real life or anything like that, what would you assume would happen to them? I'm thinking burn victim. Back injury?
Fused spine?
Fused spine? Oh, yeah.
We didn't have the cell borders on Sly.
No. Sly's cane could transform into many unique devices, including this fabulous number, which would allow you to see an invisible maze.
So amazing. We were so bad in the term to put this in the game. This level went through the entire development process. Everybody in the office touched it. At least once.
Yeah. It's funny that parts of this level actually did ship in Sly 1. Sly versus the huge pistons. Why is Sly always evading large machine parts? If I ever get rich, I'm gonna hide all my money around
huge moving parts.
With open fire pits.
Yeah, I love to fire right near my folding paper cash. Oh, check out that dynamic move. Actually, it's interesting. This is a really, really old movie, but Sly's still doing those cane swings off of books.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Was that where you came up with the idea for the cane in the first place?
No, it was more of a question mark.
Actually,
it was
Because he's a raccoon of mystery?
Mystery.
Which is clearly evident in this video. Who is that masked character swinging on the glowy?
The one thing that I kind of wish that we didn't get rid of was this, the original idea was that Sly's eyes, you should always be able to see them, even in the dark. So, like, you'll see here, when he turns around, if he ever turns around again, but how his eyes pop out.
Yeah. Oh, remember that checkpoint with the Sly logo on it? We had a lot of arguments internally about whether or not there would be Sly iconography in the world that belonged to the boss.
Oh, yeah, totally.
Dude, it'd feel more like stealing if you didn't run across stuff that belonged to you.
Yeah. He's finally made it. He's made it in.
I like that most of our conversations internally are about what would make it feel more like thieving or being a thief. At this point, I think we're pretty aware of what it takes to be a thief, and if we lose our jobs,
we got another line of work.
Yeah, we've got our second career is all lined up.
Oh, the freeze fish.
Oh yeah.
Like it made sense that you wanted to slide be able to freeze things. We'll be recognizing.
Yeah, well, we got a note, right?
Yeah.
Like players will not know that they can freeze water, so they should need something iconic. Yeah.
Yeah.
Who doesn't want to freeze a fish? Oh, the crab takes it again. And this is...
I like that we made the NPC orange so that you can't tell from where he is on the floor.
Oh, right. So orange NPC on
an orange
platform. That's part of his cunning camouflage ploy.
Totally.
If anyone asks, it was completely to make the NPC look extra so smart. Money popping up out of holes.
So interesting seeing the character without his cell phone.
I really like that old thing where the money would fly like butterflies into your pack.
Yeah.
It's pretty, sort
of
surreal.
Yeah.
But it's
rewarding.
Yeah. Didn't we have problems using green money because it wouldn't localize into different countries? Really illustrates a problem globally that we have different colored money. The video game industry would really benefit from one colored. Oh, the underwater approach.
Yeah.
You'll notice that's the same fish that was the freeze fish. Just kept reusing it. Slap. Oh yeah, you can change the wings on the underwater vehicle to go through different openings in the cave.
Yeah, if I remember correctly, Raleigh's level was supposed to entirely be underwater.
Yeah. Yeah, that was going to be our first level of the game, underwater, because it was going to be easier to do it that way.
Oh, man.
Oh. Very intense.
This is amazing.
This old Sly, it's good.
Was this PC?
I don't know. You know, frankly, like, I've blocked this Sly out of my memory. As far as I'm concerned, the Sly we know today kind of sprang up, fully formed. He's like got boxing gloves on and big clown shoes.
Clown feet.
Yep. Oh, but check it out. He's a dynamo in action. Wow. What's that up ahead? Stairs. Oh, yeah. Video games are all about like fantasy fulfillment, and here we're fulfilling the fantasy of ascending up a blue staircase. But watch out, kids! There's lava up ahead. Yeah, I never really noticed, but Sly's in a lot of caves in these demos.
Careful, Sly.
Yeah.
Careful, Sly.
Don't trust ambiguously shaped objects. Dev, I don't know if you know it, but orange means lava.
Lava.
Totally.
Lava is bad for video game characters.
In a video game character? Yeah. Game?
Lava. It is. At least in most video games, that's the case. However, in our game, we decided that it didn't hurt Sly at all.
Oh my goodness.
Oh yeah, yeah. So he could run in lava.
Yeah.
Whereas the modern Sly, he can't swim.
Totally. Totally. But he can run in lava. It's the clown shoes.
Completely. He used to be a lot tougher.
Yeah.
Is what this video tells me. Yeah, it's an impressionistic painting. It's a Dutch masterpiece. I kind of miss the Sucker Punch era of rolling lava rocks. I feel like that was a real staple for us.
Yeah. Not too thiefy, though.
Not too thiefy, no. Oh, the big guy, the original, the progenitor. Check out that mean run.
I have nothing to say about that. That was cool.
You did the mocap for that run, didn't you? Oh, here he is in his most modern form. Whereas I did the mocap for this sequence.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. That looks better than the original slide model we just looked at. Yeah. I kind of missed the purse, though.
Really?
No, not really. Hey, it's still doing the hook swing. Mm-hmm. Same as way back when. Still got the giant machine parts.
Yes, yeah. In caves.
Yeah, in caves. There's a lot more catapults in the new game, though, than in past games.
It's because those environments were so big.
That's true. Environments have gotten big. Just like Monaco, really. Like, that was a big departure, and it really is what we're doing these days. Like, this street here is just like that one in Monaco.
Yep.
This would significantly more gunplay. That's interesting to look at the computer monitor section of that gameplay. Is the how much more abstract everything's gotten from those original kind of very linear level design. I mean, we clearly wouldn't have even thought about multiplayer. Venice is the same kind of romantic getaway Monaco was.
Monaco, yeah.
Of course, multiplayer, it's not so romantic.
No. Well, that's that. That was really painful.
Show your bling and let me shine you.
On the mic.